Hey folks, how you doing? This is Shock in our continuing series of how to debate an atheist and defeat them every single time. Every single time you will defeat them. We're going to get on the motorcycle here and get on the freeway, and we're going to be talking about some of the arguments atheists bring up and how they fail in epic fashion. So you're going to see a little bit of fog, okay, is for about a minute till I start picking up speed, and then the fog will go away. So let not your hearts be troubled. We're going to talk about some good stuff today. You're going to like this video. Here we go. I see it's not fogged up too bad yet, but once I get out there on the streets, we'll be okay. That wasn't too bad. Should be unfogging any second now. So let's talk about some things that atheists bring up, like evolution, by the way. So let's start with that. Okay, first of all, I don't know why atheists bring up evolution as if that were to prove that evolution's true, number one. And secondly, how does that prove that God doesn't exist? Remember, you're an atheist, you're not a theist, right, my atheist friend? So you want to prove that atheism is true, not theism. So why would they bring up God's creation? So let's talk about this, and why, if you're in a debate with an atheist, did they bring up evolution? Hey, that's great. You've won that debate if that's all they're going to bring up. And even if they brought anything else up, I'll show you other topics they bring up and how to defeat them in debate every single time as we get them to tap out in the match, in the Ultimate Fighting Championship match, as they tap out. But first, let's get on the freeway and we'll talk about evolution, how it is going extinct this century, believe it or not. Alright, sometimes I'll be in a debate and I'm surprised at how often the atheists shy away from evolution, because even they know it's an epic fail. Alright, finally we're getting on here. Pick up some good speed. Sometimes I'll be into, wait a minute, let's get in this debate because this guy's flying behind me. Sometimes I'll be in debate and not often will the atheist bring up evolution because they know it's not true, is what they really know. But they know that even if evolution were true, which it's not, which I'm going to show you, that even that doesn't prove that atheism is true and that God does not exist. So let's go through it. Go through this. I never understood why atheists bring up evolution so much. It doesn't prove that God doesn't exist. Even evolution and all that it claims, even if we take it at face value that it's true, which it's not, but even if you did, it doesn't claim to know what created life. All it's talking about is how things change over time. And even the most conservative Christian would agree that we have change over time. Now, evolution does not say that life originated by purely natural processes. It doesn't say that at all. It doesn't deal in the origination of life, how life originated. It only deals with how life changes over time. For example, see how I'm riding? I'll use my motorcycle as an example.
See how I'm riding on this motorcycle? This motorcycle is the product of intelligent design. And I was talking to an atheist. I said, somebody created this motorcycle. This is a very good analogy of evolution, right? Which all evolution is God's creation. They just want to put an atheistic name on it. A Darwinistic name. So, check out the motorcycle. Product of intelligent design, right? All the parts here, I'm telling the my atheist evolutionist, Darwinist, this is a product of intelligent design. And they said, nuh-uh, Shock. That's their favorite word, nuh-uh. They always use the nuh-uh of the gap. They said, nuh-uh, Shock, a factory did it. Now, just to show you the utter stupidity of the atheist evolutionist. Who made the factory? Right, mankind made the factory. The product of intelligent design. And likewise, nobody disagrees with things changing over time and some things are going extinct, etc. Nobody disagrees with that. Otherwise, the atheists are all excited about that. Everyone agrees with that. But let me tell you some things that evolution does not prove. Hold on a second. And why, if you're in a debate with an atheist and they bring up evolution, you should smile ear to ear because you just won that debate. Nowhere in the neo-Darwinian theory does it say how life originated. It doesn't say God didn't create life and it evolved all by natural processes and it was originated by natural processes. It doesn't say that at all. Why are the atheists so excited about evolution? I don't get that. Okay, so let's go through a few things and then I'm going to get more into this evolution argument. Number one. Let's take this as a fact, as it is. Number one, and even the most hardcore atheists will have to admit it, even though evolution's not true, and I'm going to show you why, but even though evolution is not true, even if it was true, evolution does not claim God doesn't exist. Christians still can believe that God used a process of change over time, and of course Jesus is going to return, and of course we're going to have eternal life, and of course God exists. You see what I'm saying? It doesn't make any sense why atheists are so giddy. Why are atheists so giddy about evolution? Even if it was true, and that's a big if because it's not, but even if it was true, the atheists still lost the debate because they cannot show how evolution shows God doesn't exist. And it doesn't claim to. In defense for that stagecoach horse-owning, you know, Darwin was riding around, they were riding around in stagecoaches and horse and buggies back then. Such outdated science. But even if Darwin was right, it still doesn't prove that atheism is true, and it still doesn't prove that God does not exist. So let's go through some things why the majority of the world rejects. Do you know the majority of the world rejects the majority of evolution? Did you know that? Go to creation.com. creation.com, and there's even a group of scientists. These are scientists that formerly believed in evolution. They're now saying that the neo-Darwinian synthesis, it's fraud. They're saying it. Hold on a second. They're saying that it's not true. Lots of biologists, evolutionary scientists also. So here's some things that are not true about evolution. Number one, it does not claim that God doesn't exist. And number two, it doesn't claim to know how life began. See, listen closely. Evolution is all about change over time. It's not about how life originated. That's not evolution. So evolution would not help the atheist in any way. Now, let's go through some things that are downright dishonest and have been proven untrue. The Darwinian tree of life. Darwin's tree of life. This is a little cartoon drawing, which is not backed up by the fossil evidence. You have a tree of life which talks about how life could have evolved and changed, but it does not jive, it doesn't sync up, it's not consistent with the fossil evidence. It's not true at all. So that's a big problem. And do you know that now they're saying evolution is going extinct this century? It's dead. The neo-Darwinian synthesis is dead. But even at its face, it certainly doesn't prove that atheism is true. Number two, there's a lot of disagreement on common ancestry. That is the belief that everything evolved from simple forms to complex. There's a huge debate going on because there's arguments on both sides, and I'm going to give you some arguments against that. First of all, think for a moment about a bat and a whale. They're both mammals and vertebrates, right? Think for a moment. Of all the transitional fossils and all the transitional forms that would have to exist for a bat and a whale to share common ancestry. You know how a bat looks, right? And you know how a whale looks. Well, on the Darwinian tree of life, he would have them sharing this because they're both mammals and vertebrates. Where are these transitional fossils? We don't have any of them. And for a bat and a whale to share common ancestry, guys, we should literally have millions upon millions upon millions. We should be swimming in the fossils. We're not, and we have a lot of fossils. Do you know that we have a lot of fossils? We just don't have transitional fossils. Fossils showing how a species transitions to another species. What they'll do, what the evolutionists will do, which is very dishonest, is they'll get some cartoon drawing of one species and they'll put it next to a cartoon drawing of another species, but they don't have fossil evidence showing that it transitioned, but they'll say, because these things kind of look in a way the same, not exactly, but in a way, therefore they transitioned into each other. It's like religion. The evolution is religion. So the tree of life is already proven fraudulent. Darwin's tree of life. Also, another problem is, and this is a major problem, they were saying, well, mutations cause all this change over time. And now that has been debunked. I'm starting to sprinkle just a bit. Now that has been debunked. There's not enough time, even in our supposed 4+ billion years that the age of the Earth has been around, that they tell us. I don't agree with that. you ever go to Wikipedia, which is an atheist site, by the way, run by atheists, you ever go to Wikipedia, type in age of the earth, they've changed the age of the earth like 30 times. They keep changing it. They're trying to make it older and older and older to fit in with Darwinian, neo-Darwinian synthesis, but the theory of it. But the problem is, it's still not enough time, even on their time frame. Get this, hold on. Barrow and Tipler had a book that they had written called The Cosmologic Anthropic Principle, I believe it was. Cosmological Anthropic Principle. Something like that. And in their book, they said that even the supposed age of the Earth, over 4 billion years old, they said even using that timetable, neo-Darwinian synthesis fails. They said it's not enough time for things to develop. For example, like our inner skeleton, our eyes, our respiratory system. They said even 4 billion years, 4.6 billion even, would not be enough time. They said the sun, seeing up there in the sky, would have already ceased to be a main sequence star and would have incinerated the Earth. Well, then what am I still doing here? No, if anything, the evolution argument is proof and evidence of a creator. I mean, look at the complexity of the cell. Look at DNA, which is empirical proof of design. Now, sometimes what happens, and this is very weird when atheists do this, sometimes what happens, I'll be in a debate and they'll say, well, like you can tell they're already waving the white flag of surrender because now they're willing to say, okay, God exists. But then they'll say, but which God is it? Now, you ever have that? They'll say, well, why isn't it the God of Islam? Why isn't it a Hindu God? Why is it? And that does not help you, atheists, by conceding that, okay, God exists, but why isn't another God? You see, it's a strange, weird sort of atheism that says, okay, God exists, but it's not the Christian God, it's the God of Islam or the Hindu God. You see how the atheist already starts losing a debate because rather than giving arguments against God's existence, they throw their arms up in defeat and say, okay, but why is it the Christian God? See, they love all the other gods but the Christian God. You ever notice that? They love Thor. They love Zeus. I should say Zeus. They love Zeus. Zeus doesn't hold them accountable for their sin. Alright, so we talked about evolution not showing that atheism is true. We talked about also why evolution is false. And I'm just telling you guys on YouTube, some of you atheists, if you're watching this and you make all these evolution videos, you're going to feel like a fool. Of course, you already are a fool according to Scripture. Scripture says atheists are fools. But you're going to feel even more like a fool, even more foolish. Within this century, the neo-Darwinian theory is toast. They're already saying that mutations is not the cause. They're saying that there's no evidence that neo-Darwinian theory is true. And a lot of these atheist evolutionists on YouTube doing all these videos, wasting their life away. Now they gotta take all the videos down because neo-Darwinian synthesis, it's it's dead. It's dead. Creationists win another one. Let's go to another argument. The fine-tuning of the universe. Now, the fine-tuning of the universe is one of my favorite arguments. It's called the teleological argument. Now, the teleological argument does not immediately point to design. I want to be perfectly clear on that, because I was debating an atheist the other night, and he said, well, why did you say the teleological argument immediately points to design? And I said, that's not what that argument says. So let's go through the teleological argument, how they try to debunk it, and how they fail again. But first, let's get around these cars. You notice I'm not just matter in motion. I have a mind. I can choose to go into one lane or the left. So I'm going to choose to go in the left lane here. You see why I did that? This shows that I'm not just cells and blood and arteries and a brain and a skeleton. It shows that I have a mind. I can choose to get in the left lane behind this Porsche. Now, let's go through the teleological argument. When the universe was, when the scientists looked at the universe and astronomers looked at the universe, cosmologists looked at the universe, they were literally shocked to discover that the initial conditions for the universe were fine-tuned for the existence of life. In other words, if the initial conditions of the universe weren't just right, in other words, the rate of expansion of the universe wasn't just right, entropy wasn't just right, if we didn't have it where stars formed, if that wasn't just right, all these things are called constants. And by the way, you can go to shotgunnow.net, click links, L-I-N-K-S, let's get around the Porsche. And you can look at these fine-tuned constants. There's about 40 of them. And the scientists were shocked to discover this because they believe it cannot be due to dumb luck and chance. What is this, Porsche week? It's another Porsche. If you were to change or alter one of these constants just a hair's breadth, you would destroy life here on this planet. No life at all would exist. Now, this is the argument, teleological argument. There's three possible explanations for this fine-tuning. I've never heard any other explanation. I've challenged people to give other explanations. They go, no, I agree. Those are the three possible explanations. So here they are. Dumb luck and chance. In other words, chance did it. Necessity, like physical necessity, something in natural law. Or design. Then what you do is you go through each probable cause and you see which one is more plausible, which one is more rational. Now, if you're not a bigot, and I know you're not a bigot, but I'm talking about atheists. If you're not a bigot towards God, if you're not prejudiced towards God, if you're not so insecure in your atheism that you're terrified to bring up God as an argument. You know, I believe that atheism is a crutch for those timid, wimpy people that cannot bear the reality of God's existence. Atheism's a crutch for those types of people. But go with me now through the three possible causes of this fine-tuning. Number one, and let's get in the other lane, dumb luck and chance. Well, it can't be due to dumb luck and chance. Chance doesn't cause things. Chance doesn't have causation. It doesn't create. In other words, if I had a tennis ball and I'm riding behind this truck and I throw it, let's say I throw this tennis ball 50, it takes me 50 times to throw the tennis ball to make it in the back of the bed of this truck. Did chance do it? No, I did it. Chance is just a mathematical equation we use to determine how many times it took me to throw the tennis ball in the back of the bed of the truck. And the odds of chance fine-tuning 40 of these fine-tuned constants is ridiculous. They've shown it can't be due to dumb luck and chance. But what about something in natural law, like physical necessity? Well, scientists have already shown that there's nothing in natural law and physical necessity that would cause these constants to be that way. It's like an intelligent mind did it. Well, what about design? Ah, you see how it flows very nicely when you say design. That's obviously the more plausible, rational conclusion for the fine-tuning. So everyone would agree, even the most stubborn, Kool-Aid drinking, brainwashed, Nazi goose-stepping atheist that just marches goose-step to whatever Richard Dawkins says for them to believe in. Even the most brainwashed, insane Marxist, communist, atheist. We know atheism and communism goes hand in hand. Even the most militant atheist would agree that design is more plausible. That's the teleological argument. I'm going to put some debates here below where I've used that argument. Now, sometimes the atheists will bring this. I debated a guy, Steve Likes to Curse, who conceded defeat in debate, by the way. After the debate was over, he conceded defeat. So I humbly bow myself to the ground, very humbly. He said, he brought up the lame argument atheists always bring up, which is so easy to bat away like a half-dead gnat. He said, well, we evolved into it. You can't use that argument. You can't use that escape because the Earth wouldn't even be here to evolve into. The fine-tuning happens before life is here on Earth. There wouldn't even be a sun in the sky. There wouldn't even be stars. There would be nothing to evolve into. And the argument that these atheists bring up reminds me of this. They'll say to me, Shock, well, of course the fine-tuning's here. We shouldn't be surprised. After all, if it wasn't here, you wouldn't be here to witness it. That has nothing to do with what caused the fine-tuning. Of course that since I'm witnessing that I'm alive, I shouldn't be surprised. I should accept that it was fine-tuned. Of course, I agree. But that doesn't answer the question, why was it fine-tuned? How did it happen? Here's a good analogy. The atheists say, it's like this. Let's say you're up against a wall and someone's gonna, you're gonna have 50 marksmen with rifles shoot you. And they all pull the trigger and you realize that you're not dead. Well, you shouldn't be surprised at that. That's what they're really saying with the fine-tuning. Of course you should. You should say, well, wait a minute. How could all 50 of these marksmen miss my heart when they're shooting with the rifle? There must have been a conspiracy of some sort. Of course you're rational to say, why did this happen? We're rational to say, hold on, I hope these people don't walk up the crosswalk, the sidewalk. We're rational to say, why did the fine-tuning occur? Now, we just covered that evolution doesn't prove that atheism true. In fact, it proves the complete opposite. I believe it proves God exists because it points to creation, DNA, empirical proof of design. We also showed you the fine-tuning, which they cannot debunk. they know darn well that the more plausible, probable answer is design. So click below this video, and right below this video, and you could hear me in debate. We've debated and defeated 75 atheists in a row now. 75. They bring up arguments like, you know, leprechauns, stuff like that.